Hi everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, we are going to see how to work with the Maven tool. So first of all, let us try to understand what is Maven and what is the importance of Maven in our automation. So Maven is basically a build tool which is provided by Apache Software Foundation and which is completely open source tool. So why we need to go for Maven project? So first let us understand, if I don't use Maven project, what are the problems which we have with a normal Java project? So normally whenever you create any project, so which needs some dependencies, let's say I created something called a Java project, and to complete this project, I need some third party libraries. So for example, I want to work with a database. So for that, I need to have a database related library. So for example, if I want to work with a MySQL, I need to download that library in the form of jar files. And similarly, if I want to work with something called Selenium, and then I need to download Selenium driver, so Selenium jar files and attach to that particular Java project. Similarly, if I want to work with the TestNG, I need to download TestNG jar file and then we need to add that to the project. So whenever you do some project, there are number of third party dependencies which we need to have. So once you download those libraries and attach to the project, then we will able to use certain number of classes and methods which are coming from those libraries. So when you come to the automation point, so normally when you create a normal Java project, so we need all kinds of libraries. And normally what we will do is, if it is a normal Java project, we will download all those libraries from the different websites in the form of jar files. So once you download the jar files, attach them to your build path, then automatically our project will be used all the third party libraries. And here there are two important problems. The first problem is we need to download all the libraries from different websites. Not only two or three, so there are so many types of libraries which we need to complete our project. So to do this, we need to go to each and every website, and from there we have to download the jar files and which we need to attach them to your project. So this is a manual process we do normally. So apart from this, suppose today I have downloaded different type of libraries, third party libraries, and added to the project. So suppose tomorrow I want to upgrade this project to the latest versions. So I want to get all the latest versions of third party libraries. So then what you have to do is, we have to remove all existing libraries from your project. Then again, we have to download, again we have to add them into your project. So this is again continuous process. So these are the two major problems which you have in this. The first thing is, we have to download all the third party libraries from the different websites and attach them to our project manually. The second thing is upgradations. Tomorrow if you want to upgrade all the third party libraries into latest versions, I need to remove existing ones and then we need to add latest ones. So these are the two major problems which have with the normal projects. So to overcome these two problems, we have something called Maven tool which is available. So Maven is a huge tool which is having a lot of features, and not only these two, so we can do a lot of things by using Maven. So first we'll see what are those things we can do by using Maven. So first thing is, so Maven is a build tool which is provided by Apache Foundation, Apache Software Foundation. So Maven is called basically a build tool. So build tool is nothing but whenever you create a Maven project which will provide something called pom.xml file. So whenever you create a Maven project, by default you will get a pom.xml file. So this is the main file which we'll have in the Maven project. So the whole Maven project will be controlled by pom.xml file. Okay, pom.xml file. So let us see here, apart from these two, what are other advantages we will get by using Maven project? So whenever you create a Maven project, by default which will give you project structure. So by default, whatever the folder structure we will maintain in the project will be, by default will be provided by project structure. So that is provided by the Maven. So other than this, which will also provide you pom.xml file, so in which we will add something called dependencies. So dependencies and plugins. There are two kinds of entries we will have in the pom.xml. So one type of entry is dependencies. So when you have dependencies in the pom.xml, which will automatically download all third party libraries into your project. So that is the main advantage of dependencies. So plugins are another type of entries which we have in the pom.xml. So plugins are basically having all the configuration stuff related to the project, like compiling the whole thing project and running the project and some other type of configurations which we can specify inside the plugins. So pom.xml is contains the dependencies and the plugins. So these two will control the entire project. So here Maven is not only for downloading the jar files and upgrading the files. Not only that, apart from this, Maven also can provide you project structure, and in the pom.xml we can add dependencies and plugins. Also by using Maven, we can also generate some reports, and we can also generate some documentation, project related documentation. Okay, project related documentation also we can possible, and reports also we can generate. And by using Maven, we can also package the project. Packaging is one more important feature which we have. So packaging means once you've done your project, you don't provide the entire project, hardcore project to client. So we need to package it and we can submit the project. So packaging is also possible by using Maven software. So apart from this, there are so many uses which we have by using Maven, but especially in automation, majority of the scenario, like we will have Maven project to maintain the third party libraries, which will automatically download all the libraries, third party libraries. And also suppose tomorrow if I want to upgrade them, so in the pom.xml we have something called dependencies, and these are the dependencies which are responsible for downloading all third party libraries. So suppose tomorrow if you want to upgrade it, we can just change the version numbers in the dependencies accordingly, which will upgrade the with the latest version. So that is the mechanism which is already there in our Maven project. So now let us try to understand how exactly the Maven project works internally, how it is going to download all the third party libraries from the different websites, and how it will keep inside the project, how our project will refer those third party libraries. So now we'll see how the Maven project works internally. So basically, as I said, as soon as you created your Maven project, so by default we will get the pom.xml file. So that's the main file which we have in the Maven project. So when I take pom.xml file, in the pom.xml file we have something called dependencies. So dependencies, this is one type of entries. The second type of entries is called plugins. So dependencies, plugins. So what is the difference between dependencies and plugin? Dependencies are basically responsible for downloading the third party libraries and drivers which are related to our project, which are related to your Maven project. But what is the use of plugins? Plugins contains a different type of configurations on which our project will run. So the main important one is like a Maven Surefile plugin, Maven Compiler plugin. So there are different plugins are available. So plugins contains the configurations, and dependencies contains the which are responsible for downloading the third party libraries, or we can say in the jar files. So most of the times libraries are available in the form of jar files. So these are the two kinds of entries which we'll have in the pom.xml. So now how we will get these dependencies in the pom.xml? So in the pom.xml, as I said, dependencies, right? So suppose I want to download something called Selenium libraries into your project. So to download Selenium libraries into project, normally what happens is we will add some dependency in our pom.xml file. So in the pom.xml file, we have something called dependency. So here we have something called dependencies tag, and here dependencies, this is the end tag. So inside this we will specify all kinds of dependencies which are required for our project. So once we add this dependency, which will automatically download the third party libraries and jar files into our project. So as soon as you created your Maven project, which will internally creates Maven local repository. So this is Maven local repository. So as soon as you create your Maven project, by default which will create Maven local repository, so that will be available inside your project. So as soon as you added some dependency here in the some piece of XML file, XML code, so which will automatically download all the libraries or third party jars into Maven local repository. So from where it will download? From remote Maven repository. This is your remote Maven repository. So all the libraries whatever libraries we need for project, all the libraries are available inside the remote MVN repository, remote Maven repository. So mvnrepository.com, there is a website called mvnrepository.com. So if you go to this particular website, you can find all kinds of third party libraries. So those libraries are available inside this remote Maven repository. So as soon as you created a project in your Eclipse, what happens is this particular dependency will try to get all the required libraries, whatever type of dependency we specified inside the Palmblad XML. Accordingly, it will connect to remote Maven repository, get all the related libraries into MVN local repository. And this is the first time. And because this Palmblad XML is our dependency, need internet connection here, because we need to download all the library files remotely. So all the libraries and jar files are available in the remote repository, remote Maven repository. So to get all the jars first time when you create your project, we should have internet connection. So once you are connected to internet, then only we can get all the remote Maven repository files into Maven local repository. So once you get all the libraries into your Maven local repository, then onwards your project Palmblad XML always refer those libraries. Our project will always refer those libraries from the Maven local repository. So once you get all the libraries into your local Maven repository, which is maintained in your local system within your project. So in that case, you no need internet. Once you get all the drivers and libraries from the remote Maven repository, from then onwards, you no need internet. But tomorrow, suppose if you want to upgrade your libraries, then what you have to do is, in the dependencies itself, just we need to change the version number of the dependency. As soon as you change the version number, suppose currently we have Selenium 3.x. So we got all the libraries from the remote Maven repository to Maven local repository. Currently these are available. So tomorrow I want to upgrade with the 4.x, Selenium 4.x. Then what I have to do, in the dependencies itself, we have to just change the version number. That will automatically remove the existing libraries from the Maven local repository and get the latest libraries from the remote Maven repository. So this is a continuous process. So that's how internally Maven works. So Maven will have Palmblad XML. In the Palmblad XML, we have something called dependency concept. Once you add this dependency, this particular dependency will get all the libraries from the remote Maven repository. So all the libraries are present in one place. From there, we can get into local Maven repository. So once you get in the local Maven repository, our project will use all the libraries from our local Maven repository. Tomorrow, if you want to upgrade them, then you have to just change the version number in the dependency. Accordingly, it will get the latest library files and it will automatically remove the all already available libraries from the local repository file. So this is how actual Maven software works. So to first time when you create a Maven project, we need internet connection so that Palmblad XML dependencies will get all the libraries from the remote Maven repository. So dependencies are most useful, and whatever libraries are required for our project, we can specify those dependencies list in the Palmblad XML. So this is the one type of entry. So in the Palmblad XML, we also have something called plugins. So apart from the dependencies, we also have something called plugins. So all the plugins are included in the plugins tag. So here we can specify all the plugins. So what is the use of plugins in the Palmblad XML? So basically, project related configurations we will specify in the plugin. Suppose I want to compile entire project, then we need to add compiler plugin, Maven compiler plugin. Suppose I want to run whole project, then Maven Surefile plugin is required, which we need to add here. Suppose I want to package the whole project, then we need additional plugin is required. Suppose our application need to start. Suppose our application is a web-based application, I want to start and stop server every time. So to do those kind of operations, we will also add some additional plugins. So basically, plugins will control the entire project. So configurations we will specify in the plugin. So these plugins will control the project or organize the complete project. But what dependencies means? Dependencies will add all the required libraries to your project, and it will automatically download all the libraries and external jar files which are required for your project. So this one will simplify our job. If I don't have a Maven project, every time you have to do manually. We have to go to each and every website, and we have to download the jar files, bunch of jar files, and we need to attach them to your again project, right? So then we need to work. Suppose tomorrow if you need to upgrade, again we have to remove existing jar files, again we need to download. So this is again tedious process. So to do this automated, what we can do is we can create a Maven project. So once you create a Maven project, Palm.xml, XML, we have to just specify the dependencies plugins, and dependencies automatically download all required libraries and jar files which are required for our project, download everything into and keep in the Maven local repository. And our project will refer all the libraries and third party files from the local repository. So this is how actual Maven project works for automation. Now in the next video, I will show you practically how we can create a Maven project, how we can specify the dependencies, what are the plugins are available, and how we can get all third party libraries into our project. So these things we will see practically in the next video. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see in the next video.